First of all, Chitali, congratulations on being, you know, a part of this elite list of E4 NTR and COPCOM 40 under 40. And as you must be knowing, Exchange for Media is, committed in recognizing and felicitating upcoming leaders across industries, and more specifically for the PR and corporate communications domain. So I would really like to start off with this video series called the Next Gen series, with you, Ms. Chitali Dave, PR manager at Nucleus PR. I think you have been a support to me for all my stories and all last moment, quotes and everything. So I think this is indeed a pleasure for us to have you, in this new series. So how do you feel being a part of this series?
First of all,
and the elite list.
Thank you so much, Nafisa, for the kind words for me. It's always give and take. Yes, we have to be like that. So really, really thank you. And I would really like to thank Exchange for Media Group for this recognition. I feel truly honored and humbled for this because, we PR people are known to be behind the scenes people. And we are always in that our client should get recognition, our client should be awarded. And here it's vice versa. You guys are giving us that recognition. So it really means a lot to me because this is the first award in my lifetime, in my career, which I have achieved.
Wow.
So this will be first in my desk. But since we all are working from home, so in my home table, this will be my first award. Which I'll be having, and it really motivates to do new things. It's close to 15 years of experience now, and finally I'm being recognized, so I really feel very good.
I think we should keep this winning streak on from now onwards, Chitali. I think I wish you all the very best for your upcoming years in this industry. So moving on to my next question, things have changed from the past couple of months, and to be very precise, the past 10 months. And, the PR industry has seamlessly adapted to the changes that have come their way. So what, according to you, are the skills required right now in this industry for the PR professionals to excel in their field, the key skills required?
Especially after this COVID has entered our life, it has changed drastically. And the one thing which already came in the industry, the digital transformation, it has accelerated more in these 9 to 10 months where you really need to know the digital thing of it. It's not only traditional media anymore. It is about digital. It's about collaboration. It's about influencer marketing. So that has changed. That has changed the PR industry drastically in these 10 months. And you really need to keep upskilling yourself every time. You can't just have that. For me, to be very honest, experience counts than a degree. Because whatever you learn is completely, aap jo padhte ho, this can't be taught what you're doing in your day to day. So, experience is something different. And, in this industry, upskilling needs to be there, be it your social, be it your content marketing. And, even the perspective of clients needs to be changed. They can't tell, okay, nahin, mujhe, I want to come in traditional media. No, even online platforms, even paid collaboration for that matter. Plays an important role in this industry. And I have seen this accelerated in this 10 months so far.
Okay. And you have talked about digital becoming, the next big thing. It was there, but now, it has been amplified. So what are the broad trends that you have noticed as an experienced PR professional that have, really shaped up this industry during these past 10 months, to be very precise, the COVID-infected months?
So
the broad trends.
Basically, the first and foremost trend, which I think has grown, is everything can happen from work, from home. We can do virtual meetings. That has been accepted largely. Actually, that's a digital transformation. For client meetings, we need to travel here and there, obviously. But this has been accepted largely now because of COVID times, and everything is happening through your virtual camera and everything. Second is, you have to be updated on what is happening. You can't just be, no, we will give you, we'll do press release, we'll do this, we'll do that. No, you have to come up with new things for every client. Okay. When this COVID entered, I'm sure you must have noticed the media bloodbaths that happened. I mean, it's a very bad thing. If media is still going through a lot of things. Recently also, there was a news which we read. So media bloodbath is still continuing. So that means that we need to grow digitally. Digital transformation is here to stay. Your podcast, your webinars, everything means a lot. So these are the trends. And as a PR professional, you need to be updated. You can't sit at one thing. You need to come up with new ideas. For that, you need to be updated for everything that's there.
So basically, upskilling and being updated is what are the broad trends according to you that will that have shaped up the PR industry by far. And also, you have been dealing with clients since many years now, since a decade, I would say. So what are the changes that you have noticed in their behavior or maybe their demands during these months, or have they become more acceptable to the needs, or have they become more reluctant?
I feel when it comes to my client, they have become receptive to whatever we say. Yeah. Because when it comes to Nucleus, so far, before COVID times, we have been stressing along that digital is the new thing that is going to come. Okay, which I think so many PR professional and PR experts have been telling. But this COVID has actually proved us right. When it comes to traditional media and everything was online, because papers were shut initially. Where would you get the coverage from? So where do we go? So online and your digital is the only way. And we have been telling them to be active on their LinkedIn, on your Twitter, on their social media platforms. So that has, that has increased during these months. They have finally given that push. Okay, yes, let's do that. So for us, it has been a receptive thing. Yes, we all the PR professional, I think so, were proven right during these times that you need that digital push.
And, let's talk something on the personal front also. Like, we've been working from home since the past 8 or 9 months. And you are a mother of two very cute little kids. So what has been that, how has been that experience of, balancing both the lives together at the same place? How has that experience been for you?
It's been crazy. And I have been telling you these a few times. I preferred this time because they are asleep right now. So hence we can have this chat peacefully. Initially, it's not that I haven't worked from home. I have been worked from home. But now initially it would be like 1 day or 2 day. Okay, if you have something. But now it's a plus point for them because they see me every day. So for them, this laptop and mouse is like a khilona for them that, okay, mama, what are you doing? What are you not doing? So initially it was a bit tough and crazy for me, challenging for me. But slowly, slowly, I made them understand that, see, when mama is on call, when I'm on call, I need to do these actions that, you don't need to come near me. You don't need to disturb me. If at all they are there, I have plenty of the toys which make them, okay, now let's do this. So it has been a challenging times, but now I think so even they have understood that mama is here. She is going to work and we are not supposed to disturb her, but still somehow they do that. They are kids, we can't do anything. And a lot of support from my husband as well, who have been there for me all the time. So crazy thing, balancing work. And obviously, my boss has been really understanding. She does understand a lot of things. Because, when you're working from home, it's not only a mother. When it comes to women, you have to cook food. You have to do this. You have to do that. So, many of things that needs to be taken care of. So that's really important. It's not that a mother or anyone. Even being a male PR professional, you also have other household works to be done. So that really to be balanced. It took me like month or a two to, you know, balance this out, but I'm still doing it and I'm managing it.
You did it. You came as winner, right?
So
while you were working from home, did you face any technological glitches or maybe some Wi-Fi problem or anything? How technologically enabled are we or are the PR professionals now? And if we need to take this to the next level, are we completely ready to go fully virtual now?
I would say personally, I would say that we are 80% ready, okay? But still okay. That 20% when it comes to still somewhere, you know, I feel that face-to-face meeting is important. At some point, you know, we are not ready for full virtual thing or for full virtual office also for that matter. You know, I have read many of the things that, you know, people are... They have given 2 years of thing that, you know, now the firms will work only from home. But I think so somewhere we are still not ready for that full 100% technology.
Okay. And if you talk specifically about Nucleus PR, so what is the technological infrastructure like? And... How will you guys be upgrading yourselves or adding new features in this particular aspect?
So basically, see, when we started working from home, there are few things which we initially figured. Like, you know, having your daily calls, weekly calls. Initially, there were monthly meetings. So when this COVID came into our world, into our life, we made sure that few protocols needs to be followed because... everybody is working from home. We need to have that trust matter, right? When you're working from office, you can see everybody working. But from working from home, so, you know, we really made, we set protocols. We did weekly calls. We did, we have been given Wi-Fi and infrastructure to all our employees. We made sure that there's no glitch when there are calls and everything because things were changing drastically. There was a shift altogether. So all these, you know, weekly calls, monthly, Tarunjit Ratan, she's also there fortnightly on each and every call with clients and with us that what is happening, what is not happening. And that has proven to be very nice, you know. It's good to be updated for everything.
Absolutely.
So that is as a Nucleus PR and we are still continuing that.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So now as you have been recognized, you know, as... one of the emerging leaders in this PR industry, to be like specific. So what are the qualities according to you that you find important for being a leader? Let's talk about three important qualities that you would like to have in yourself as a leader and for others also.
One is listen. The first thing is you need to listen. You know, you just can't say whatever you want to. You really need to understand the other side of it. You know, in this 15 years of journey, you know, I have learned a lot. I have been right from cut paste of papers in those when you used to give the dockets to the client, right from doing those AV sheet, taking that scale and thing. You should, one is listen. One is, I think so, you should be down to earth. You know, that really means a lot to all the employees because you shouldn't have that, okay, you're a manager of Mumbai office and you should be approachable. When I mean down to earth, you should be approachable to everything. And last, work as a team member.
Absolutely.
Not as a team manager. Work as a team member. Work as an employee to them. Always make them feel that you are always available for them.
So these and give that benefit of doubt to people, right?
Yes.
Absolutely. I think all these three points are really relevant for, you know, upcoming leaders and for people who are looking up to professionals like you to enter the industry, right? Yes. So, you know, talking about the PR industry, and you have been a part of it since a long time. So what, you know, how has the sentiment of this industry changed over the past 10 years, if I talk about a decade? Because a lot of, or humongous amount of changes have come during these 10 years. What are the, you know, changes according to you that have shaped up this industry?
So initially, you know, when I speak about like, it is difficult to get coverage, be it your traditional or be it online, because everybody has their own policies in place. But one is the space crunch, okay, right? Space. From 10 years, the space crunch in your print media has, it's like, I don't know, you used to get this full page coverage when I entered, and now it's just a part, like a snippet, you get it covered. So the media industry has changed. Second, you really need to be, you really need that bang on point to approach to any of them. Initially, things, the media rounds and everything, obviously, still it makes a difference. But like I know you, okay, versus I know anyone else, there is going to be a huge difference, because you will listen to me, because we share that rapport, you know. Rapport building is very important, is very important in PR industry. And that has really shaped up, because from here to there, you need to maintain that thing. Yeah. Second is, obviously now there is a huge competition in online and your social media and your content marketing and your influencer marketing. So these are new things which have come recently. So that is also a new thing, which is a very, very interesting and awesome thing which we are learning right now. We are still in learning phase, be it your podcast, because podcast is still at a very, very nascent stage. It has still not gone to where your print and your online has gone, right? Your webinars and everything. Yeah. So interesting things which have come up. The only thing which I say, that to all clients and PR professional, be open to learn whatever it is. Changes are there to come. One thing is there, nothing is permanent. So you need to be ready for everything.
We need to be open for changes that will be coming across. I think change is the only constant that we have been, you know, working on. Absolutely. So moving on to my second last question, that would be, what according to you would you be the key innovations that would reshape the PR and popcom industry?
I think so, collaborations. Because right now, obviously, apart from doing your daily routine PR that you do it, collaborations are, and digital collaborations are going to play a really, really key thing in upcoming. You are already seeing the sneak of it. Right now, but I think so these are going to play a huge role when it, I think so somewhere down the line you will see this. Collaborations are going to play a huge role. It can't be only one player. You have to collaborate and you have to work together for achieving that goal.
Okay, collaborations, and of course being technologically adept now.
Yes, so anyway, we see technology has come into our lives when this COVID has come. I think so there are a lot of positive things that this COVID has brought, apart from the negative thing, obviously, which nobody would want to speak about it. But if we speak about positive things, there are many things which COVID has brought, and we need to learn from it.
Yes, so let us all be guarded with our optimistic thoughts, Chaitali. So just to end this really insightful and interesting interactions, what is your message to the budding PR professionals that are there in the industry, and to those who are, you know, willing to join the industry? Your key message to your juniors.
Okay, so first and foremost is, please be calm and patient. Okay, as soon as you're entering the market, because once you're entering from your college and you're moving into an agency, there is a huge difference. So you need to keep calm. You need to be patient. You need to listen, and you know, please don't change the job as soon as possible because of any other thing. Because if you keep on hopping from here and there, you will not learn anything. So So be calm and be patient. At least be in your firm for at least for a year so that you learn wherever you want to join. Okay. Second is read newspapers every day. Every day. It's very essential, be it your newspapers, be it your InShorts or whatever you're comfortable with. That needs to be there. And second, be ready for upskilling yourself. You need to do that. You really need to do that. This is the time of an hour where you need to do this. Even I'm doing it right now. So hence, because this is a personal experience, so that really needs to be a part of everything. Because you know what happens,
all the juniors that
what happens after the point of, you know, okay, you have 15 years of experience, but everybody thinks that okay, that she knows what was happening, but what now? So be ready for all the changes. Be receptive. Be calm. Be patient. There are many things in this PR professional. It's like a magic treasure. As and when you put your hands in, there are many, many new spells which come out.
A very dynamic industry. So I think all the juniors who will be listening and all your colleagues who will be listening to this video would definitely agree to whatever you said. And once again, congratulations, Shetali, on being a part of this, the second edition of the E4M PR and Copcom 40 and 40 list. We wish you all the best. And that's the celebration.
Yes.
You know, continue. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Nafisa, and thank you, Exchange for Media Group, for this. Thank you so much.